Construct an isosceles triangle whose base is 8 cm and altitude is 4 cm. Then draw another triangle whose sides are 1/2 times the corresponding sides of the isosceles triangle. Okay. So 1/2 is equal to, we should multiply this 2 into 1 plus 1 divided by 2. So this will give us 3/2. So corresponding sides should be 3/2 of an isosceles triangle. Okay. First, let us draw a rough diagram. Base should be 8 centimeters and it should be an isosceles triangle. Okay. So this is 8 centimeters base. Let us take this as AB. Okay. Isosceles triangle means two sides should be equal, right? So AC and BC are two equal sides now. Okay. So this AC and BC lengths are not mentioned. He gave us the base is 8 and altitude. Altitude means height of the triangle, right? So this is the altitude of the triangle. This should be equal to 4 centimeters. Okay. So let us construct a triangle like this. What we'll do is we'll draw the base 8 centimeters and then we'll draw perpendicular bisector to AB. Okay. Let us see here. Base is 8 centimeters first. Okay. Let us draw base 8 centimeters. This is 8 centimeters line. Okay. Let us name it AB. Alright. Let us draw perpendicular bisector of AB. See, this is approximately half. So we should take more than half of AB, right? So this is more than half. One line above AB, one arc above AB, one arc below AB, right? And same thing from A. One arc above AB and one arc below AB. Okay. So let us join this. Let this be M. M is now the midpoint of AB. Okay. Alright. Now here, if this is M, this is 8 centimeters base, the CM should be 4 centimeters. Okay. So what we'll do is, we'll measure 4 centimeters and draw an arc from M. Okay. 4 centimeters here. Let us measure 4 centimeters, slightly greater than 4. Okay, this is 4 centimeters. Alright. So with M as center, let us draw an arc. Alright. I hope you are able to see this. Everything is very close here. So this is point C. Alright. This will be 4 centimeters. See here, this is 4 centimeters and this is 8 centimeters base AB. Alright, let us join C with A and C with B. Now this is the given triangle ABC. To this triangle, we should construct a triangle whose sides are 3/2. Okay, corresponding sides should be 3/2. Alright, so we should draw a ray here, right? Let it be AX. Okay, the ratio is 3/2, right? So what was our trick? We should take the denominator. It doesn't matter whether the scale factor is greater than 1 or less than 1. Whatever the denominator number is, first we should draw those many arcs here on AX. Okay. So denominator in our case is 2. So we'll draw 2 arcs now of equal length, of equal radii. 1 and 2. Okay, let us name them. This is A1, this is A2. Now we should join B with A2. Alright. Now we should draw a parallel line to BA2 from the numerator number, that means from A3. But A3 is not there here, right? That means we should have drawn one more arc, right? So I did not change this radius. Now from A2, let me draw one more arc here. So let us name it A3 now. Okay. So we should draw a parallel line to BA2 from A3, right? There are two ways which we can use, either compass or we can use protractor. Okay, we are using protractor. So what is this angle from A2? Let us measure the angle. It is 71 approximately, right? Nearly 71. So from A3 also we should mark an angle 71. Okay, so this is 71. I hope you are able to see this is the point. Now let us join A3 with the point and extend that. Okay, so this line is parallel to BA2. Of course this line will not intersect AB because the triangle which we are going to draw is a bigger triangle, right? So let us extend this line AB and the point of intersection be B dash. Okay, so this is B dash. Now we should draw a parallel line to BC from B dash. Okay, so let us measure the angle again here. It is 46 approximately. Okay, so from B1 also we should mark 46 angle, degrees angle. Okay, all right, and extend AC now. So this point of intersection is C dash. Okay, so A, B dash, C dash is our required triangle.